I can talk to Erwin Laszlo today. Erwin Laszlo is, amongst other things, the founder and chancellor of the Giordano Bruno Global Shift University. He's a philosopher of science, a system theorist, and a system philosopher. On this very beautiful day here on the EMCSR 2012, we can talk with each other. I'm glad to be here. So, talking about the European meetings on cybernetics and system research, how many times have you visited the EMCSR before?
I have been part of it before. I think Wolfgang Hofkirchen will know exactly. I think 2 years ago, I think also was part of it. And then there was a previous meeting at the end of the 90s, also on the foundations of systems, or information, foundation of information. There's very much the same people involved, Wolfgang Hofkirchen and others. So, a few years I have been visit, and of course I've been a good friend after his death to Ludwig von Bertalanffy, who was from Vienna.
How do you think the conference has developed over the years?
I think it shows the growth, a very healthy growth of interest in society of system thinking. It used to be thought a specialty that only applies to one or another thing, very special areas, living systems or technical systems. But now it turns out that almost everything we can think of around that is a system. So the interest is really recognition of the importance of system thinking is growing.
And do you think this progress will develop further in this direction? And where do you want to see the EMCSR heading to?
To recognize that this, we are dealing with an academic discipline that is very relevant to the problems we face. So it's both understanding and application, both are equally important. We have to understand in order to apply things, our thinking, thoroughly and well, but we cannot just stay put and be satisfied with only theoretical understanding. We also have to see how that understanding applies to the world around us.
This directly leads me to your very inspiring keynote you held just some moments before, and the title of the keynote was Information and Coherence in Nature and the Cancer of Human World Incoherence. So my first question is concerning that topic: how did we, our humanity and our society, become incoherent with the system? Where did we go wrong?
It's very difficult for an individual to understand that what is around us are also living systems. It looks like nature would be just passive. We used to think that what we nowadays we call dualism, dual thinking, that I and nature are separate. Woody Allen makes fun of everything. He said, nature and I, we are two. Usually said, we are one. But this kind of thinking of separating ourselves off from others, because we see ourselves that we are individuals and the most other people around us are others, and nature is something different, and matter is quite different. So that's a natural way of thinking. But it's a mistaken way at the same time, because when you look closer, you find that all of these are tied together with relationships that create systems around us. All of the power of life on Earth is a giant system, sometimes called the Gaia giant system.
Wow. So when we head into a new society and a new culture, which values and notions do you think are crucial for achieving an effective new culture?
Consciousness and responsibility. At the same time, ethics comes, of course, into that. Consciousness, because we can choose our actions, we can be conscious. Unlike most other species, I think we are the only species that has this evolved ability to foresee the consequences of our actions. So we have to consciously choose actions that have positive consequences, good results. And then we have to accept the responsibility for choosing the right actions. If we are part of a community of human beings, part of our local community and the global community both, part of also the ecological community, then as members of those communities, we have to be a responsible so that we act in a way that doesn't damage the environment.
This directly leads me to my next question, which is, do you think that our current society is capable of becoming consciousness and of having those values and notions which are essential for our culture?
The current society, yes, society means people, yes, of course the people have to change, but the current culture has to change. So the current culture is not capable, I don't think, because it will have to be fundamentally changed. But our society can change. We can have different cultures, we can evolve as individuals. We can't change our genetics, we can change our culture.
So summing up your keynote, what would you like the people who attended to take with them?
Recognition of their responsibility of systems thinkers to bring ideas to people around them that will lead us into a more positive direction. And then, as Gandhi said, for they themselves to be the change that they want to see in the world. That is, they be conscious, systemic members of the systems of the world.
When you talk about change, I read some work of yours, and you always mention the young generation and the new generation, which is a highly interesting topic for us young students, because it affects us directly. And you say that our generation, the young generation, is faced with the challenges of change. And my question is, how can the young generation meet the challenges of change?
Well, that would take us a couple of hours. But in a very, very brief way, become conscious of being part of a tremendous evolutionary trend. Being part of an evolutionary wave that is moving, that is not static, that moves forward. And to be a conscious, positive part, move is the wave, healthy wave to unfold.
So, and what concretely do you think we can do in our everyday lives?
Choose the topics that you study so they become relevant to this change, and then when you come to new insight, then apply to yourself also, and to the way that you talk to other people, the young people around you.
So thanks for that advice, and thanks for that very beautiful interview. Is there anything you would like to add?
My case is in the young generation, is in your generation. I don't think you think the same way that my generation has thought when I was your age. You're much more aware, you're much more a part of a larger system, becoming aware of that. So I think it's up to you to create a new world.
Thank you.